Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we come to you this hour asking for your blessing as we are gathered together. We pray for guidance in the matters at hand and ask that you would clearly show us how to conduct our work with a spirit of joy and enthusiasm. Give us the desire to find ways to excel in our work. In your name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay. Is there a motion to approve the minutes from March 2nd, 2023 meeting?
I move the motion.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Approval of the bill. I would propose to.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We'll start with accounts payable. This cycle for accounts payable totals $760,344.15. Payroll is $362,478.74. Item on one account totals $34,570.85. And finally, two checks through the CBG account for $46,365.47. Make a motion to pay the bills.
I'll second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Treasury report, Treasury.
Good morning.
Morning.
Treasurer's report covers the span from 3/1 through 3/14/2023. General account starting balance is $4,604,758.80. Total debits $844,982.82. Treasurer's office agrees with the bills paid as read by Commissioner Coastal. We have an ending balance in the general account of $4,326,918.73. Other ending balances start with liquid fuels at $324,664.62, Act 89 with a balance of $506,818.96. 911 telephone account has an ending balance of $403,151.45. LEPC is $24,243.29. Local use fund ends the period with $612,158.51. And finally, capital reserve ending balance is $5,746,482.49.
Thank you. Your motion to accept the Treasury report.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
I gave a list to the chief clerk for the minutes. I do want to point out that next week I will be attending the CCAP board of directors meeting starting on Saturday and the conference ending on Tuesday. Most of the topic will be the governor's budget. Thank you.
Okay, Commissioner Page.
Yes, I provided my list to the chief clerk as well, and I'd like to welcome Zeta Fry and Cassie Himes from MCTV here today. Thank you for filling for us.
I too provide a list. Public comment, is that public comment? Okay, under new business, we have a Vietnam War Veterans Day proclamation, March 29, 2023.
Commissioner Page. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Proclamation, Vietnam War Veterans Day, March 29th, 2023. Whereas, as we honor all the men and women who served in our nation's armed forces throughout history, Mifflin County is proud to join the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania in the national commemoration of Vietnam War Veterans Day. And whereas, this conflict defined an entire generation of Americans, and numerous brave men and women served during the conflict, including 325,208 Pennsylvanians, of whom 3,147 Pennsylvanians were killed in action and 89 are still unaccounted for. And whereas, as citizens of Mifflin County, we must never forget the pain and suffering that lingers today for the men and women who fought with honor and distinction in the name of freedom and democracy for all. And whereas, we remember the men and women who so honorably served during more than a decade of fighting in challenging terrains of Southeast Asia, where they faced extraordinary and unprecedented dangers. We will never forget their sacrifice, and we value their continued service to their fellow veterans today. as they embody the motto of the Vietnam Veterans of America, "Never again will one generation of veterans abandon another." And whereas since their return, these veterans have contributed tremendously to their communities, the Commonwealth, and the nation. They have displayed unparalleled support for those currently serving by providing welcoming celebrations for those returning and honors for those who have fallen. And whereas through this commemoration, Mifflin County, the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, the Department of Military and Veterans Affairs, and the Office of Veterans Affairs joins with all citizens of this great state and nation to honor and remember our Vietnam veterans and their families for their courage, sacrifice, and valor. Therefore, we, the Mifflin County Commissioners, join with Pennsylvania Governor Josh Shapiro in proclaiming March 29, 2023 as Vietnam War Veterans Day. We encourage all citizens to participate in activities that bestow honor and commendation on American heroes, past and present. Proclaim the 16th day of March, 2023, Mifflin County Commissioners Sunderland, Toastal, and Koch.
Motion approved.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, the next item on the agenda is a report from Phil Lucas on the 911 center renovation. Phil's not here. He's called with an issue that's going on in Meadow Township this time. I try to have him at the next meeting on March the 30th. We have a sales agreement with Jonathan and Katie Peachy to purchase 0.75 acre property adjacent to Mifflin County 911 Allensville Tower for the amount of $10,000.
If I could explain a little bit on this, Mr. Chairman. This is additional acreage next to the acreage that we already own, and our 911 tower is on that acreage. This is to allow an expansion needed in the future and to facilitate the existing services. We're coordinating with another provider that is going to be erecting the tower adjacent to this for services, I guess, in Meadow, part of Huntington County. So that's what that's why we're purchasing this land at this time. I'll make a motion to proceed.
I'll second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. We have the Pennsylvania State Fire Academy Facility Usage Agreement for the Sheriff's Training. Motion.
This is a no-cost agreement with the Pennsylvania Fire Academy. It's to present training for the Pennsylvania State Police Drug Lab presentation. We'll be presenting this to our first responders. It is scheduled for May 9th. If anybody wants any other information, they can call Mr. Lucas at our center. This is at no cost, and thank you to the Fire Academy for allowing us to present this.
So motion approved.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We have requests for exoneration of 2023 county portion per capita taxes. We date town borough tax collector book to name at date. Juniata Terrace borough tax collector Susie Tyson has 10. Zeke Hamilton borough tax collector Melody Kane has 2. The motion to approve the exoneration.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We have revised tax claim 2023 fees and costs.
I'll make a motion to approve the new fees. I will also point out that I don't believe these fees have been adjusted for the last 3 years. Mr. Coolisi, can you add something to that?
Sure. So,
this is tax claim, not your fees. I'm sorry.
No problem.
Go ahead.
I think it's been approximately about 5 or 6 years.
5 years. Okay.
Yeah, it's a one change in the whole list.
All right, is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We have an offer for a parcel located in Derry Township that is currently in repository for unsold property. The amount of the offer is $500. Is there a motion to accept or reject that offer?
Mr. Chairman, I'm going to make a motion to reject this offer.
I'll second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We have an inmate housing agreement with Center County, a fee at the rate of $75 per day that people can be.
Yeah, this is a contract with Center County due to our influx of up and down in our population. If we ever became overcrowded, this will be like a backup plan. So it's needed at the most.
Question?
Motion to approve.
Second? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you. To an amendment to easement agreement with the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania to adjust the location of the trail agreement. Planning Director Mark Palooza.
All right. Morning.
Morning.
So for item agenda I and J, I'm going to give you the same explanation because these two items are linked to the expansion of the Juniata Trail project. This would be in the borough of Lewistown to extend the Juniata River Trail from where it terminates, basically south of where Dairy Queen is. And then it would extend it the whole way to where the property line between the State Fire Academy property is and the Lowe's property. So it would be a half a mile trail extension from what already exists, which is what would locally be known as the Rothermel Trail. So for these two particular items this morning, when we were going into design, because we have been successfully awarded two different grants, both from DCNR and DCD, as well as a lot of gracious donations from a variety of local banks and the Visitors Bureau, this project was ready to move forward. So we had our design engineer with the EADS group looking into what was being needed for taking this particular project to bid. While doing the investigation, one of the things that was needed for a permit to the DEP was to make sure we weren't making any impacts to wetlands. Unfortunately, when the surveyor was on site, there were wetlands discovered in the location where the existing easements were on those particular properties. So in order to alleviate the issues with ongoing needs to maintain or do anything with the maintenance of the restoration of a wetland, we actually are going basically around the wetland, so we don't have to impact that at all. So for these two items, we had to work with the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania through General Assembly in order to get this particular item agreed to, in order to move the location of the easement. And secondly, not only that, but also with the cemetery, the concrete plant property, because of the alignment issues, the location of the easement would need to be changed. And with both of these items, once these are potentially approved, we can record the easement, which will allow us to have a certification of title to move forward. It will allow us to put that particular project out for bid, and we're hopeful we can have that project constructed between this spring and this summer and have it done and available for people to use before the end of the year.
Question. Since we're changing it, is it going to add to the length since you're going around these wetlands now? It seems to be contradictory since we are going along the river.
Well, in total, there would be a very minimal impact to the total length just because of how it will attach to the trailhead, which will be just east of where the State Fire Academy property is along State Street. So because we're kind of going around, we're just kind of going north and west as opposed to kind of making a meandering route around it. And it just so happens with the topography work with that site. The way the concrete plant property is we would be going at a diagonal, and ultimately I think we'll end up with a better result. However, because we would go completely off of location where the existing easement is today, we would have to have these two agreements allow us to take the trail, which will, again, to specifically answer your question, not really alter the total length of the trail.
Okay.
Mark, is that first section there we talked about possibly paving, is that going to happen or is that still in the future?
So we actually did put that in there as a ad alt for the bid package. So once that project go out the bid, if that price would come in under budget, then that would be an option that you guys would have to agree to and then make that decision at that time once the bid comes in.
Chair, I move I and J for approval.
I'll second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We have a proposal from Keller Engineers to develop a bridge capital plan for municipal and county bridges, a rate of 75 to 135 per hour. Mr. Clooney.
So Keller Engineers is already designated as the county bridge engineer. They do all the inspections for all the locally owned bridges in the county. They're over the size of 20 feet. There are a few that are actually slightly less in size than that. However, because we have the local fee program, which allows us to do assist the local municipalities with the rehabilitation or replacement of local bridges, we were actually looking at coordinating with Keller Engineers because CEDACOG, who is the agency that is our transportation planning partner to get transportation funding through the Federal Department of Transportation as well as through PennDOT, there's an analysis that they do in order to get bridges funded throughout the entirety of the region. And they use a lot of analytics on how they decide on which particular projects are funded. We found that in the past previous TIPs that were awarded the transportation improvement plans, we weren't having some of our bridges funded because there are worse bridges throughout the region. But certainly we want to make sure that we are analyzing the bridges based on what the condition of them is. So since we're working with our existing bridge engineer, we were looking at expanding this particular scope of services to allow them to do additional analysis and potentially provide recommendations to the board on potentially how to use local $5 fee money, as well as making prioritization with CEDACOG on how to seek federal and state bridge improvement dollars. This particular proposal will be completely funded by state dollars that CEDACOG staff actually had found for us. So this will be 100% paid for by that particular. It's not really a grant. It's more of an amendment to their proposal, but there will be no out-of-pocket dollars to the county other than some minimal cost matching for some of these hours that Keller would be doing.
And then there will be no out-of-pocket also for the municipalities that
correct.
We're working with. So this is just an enhancement of our current bridge policy that we already have, and using the $5 fee to improve those bridges.
Okay. Your motion to approve.
So moved.
Second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
We have resolution number 8, 2023, amending the subdivision and land development review fee.
So the municipality's planning code, which is an enabling legislation in Pennsylvania, allow county planning commissions as well as local planning commissions to conduct or collect review fees in order to do subdivision or land development plan reviews to cover our costs. It allows us to truly do cover our costs. So we've been in the process of looking at what it costs to review these particular plans. There's a lot of different layers to how these plans get reviewed. These plans haven't been, the fee schedule I don't believe has been updated since 2016. So it's been quite a number of years since this fee schedule has been updated. As you can understand, our costs have gone up in order to conduct basic business. So we took a look at the fee schedule and did two things. Number one, we tried to simplify the fee schedule so that it wasn't as complicated for people to try to understand what the fee would be for whatever particular plan they'd be submitting. So there would be less fee types that would be available for them to be able to pay, but then would also potentially, in aggregate, would increase the amount of fees that we would generate, again, better cover our cost of doing business.
Any questions? Motion approved.
So moved.
Second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We have subrecipient agreement with Mifflin County Wires for County Improvement Grant Funds. Planning Director, Mr. Clusian.
So similar to items I and J, both items M and N are also linked because the county was able to be a recipient of the American Rescue Plan Act funds that allow us to be able to cover our costs for the different associated items related to the COVID-19 pandemic. The county was a recipient of a lot of those funds that allow us to cover some of the additional costs that the county would have received, or to cover some of the reduction in the revenue that the county would have gotten because of the stagnation of the economy. Those funds made it available for the county commissioners to be able to make these funds available to the county at large, or the county nonprofits, municipalities, municipal authorities, and broadband agencies throughout the county. So with that said, it gave us the flexibility to establish this particular program. There was the County Improvement Fund, which this particular process was already been announced at previous meetings that there were six nonprofit agencies and include or nonprofit or for-profit broadband agencies to be able to provide additional services that were truly being able to prove that they were impacted by the pandemic. In this particular circumstance with item M, Mifflin County Wireless has found that they can provide better broadband service throughout the county because of the increased needs for people to be able to work and access their medical community from the home. They are able to provide a service to allow increased connectivity to people using new wireless technology. And then with item N, the one dog at a time, they're finding that they're seeing an increased amount of use for their services. So this would allow their facilities to be upgraded. So again, in aggregate for both items M and N, this will allow the county to be able to execute sub-recipient agreements that would outline what the appropriate use of those particular funds are, which in the agreement it outlines specifically what those funds are for, so that once they would potentially expend those funds, we would be able to reimburse them, as long as we would be able to go out and do a verification that they did spend the funds appropriately, so that we are double checking that there's no.
Motion to approve that in.
So moved.
Second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
And may I, Chairman, is it okay? Because Mifflin County Wireless is one dog at a time, they found that they're able to move their projects a little bit faster than some of the others. We will potentially be seeing other sub-recipient agreements coming in the near future, maybe even early as your very next commissioner's meeting, but these are the first two that are able to go, so we're excited about seeing those projects move forward. So.
Thank you. We have a purchase of service agreement with Mark Lutie for planning consulting services. Motion to approve.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Do you want to go ahead?
I would say, Mr. Chairman, that, you know, we're fortunate to have a lot of very good employees in our county, and after this week, we're going to be down one. I want to just acknowledge Mark for all the great work you've done for us. We've thrown a lot of things at you, asked you a lot of questions. Sometimes you ask you the same question five times, but you've always maintained these projects for us, came over and met with us whenever we asked, and we wish you well, you and your family, while going to Missouri, and you're going to be missed.
Thank you.
Yeah, we all know, I guess, that Mark will be leaving us tomorrow is your last day, I believe, right?
That's correct.
Kind of officially tomorrow. Yes, your last day. And good luck as you move west. I'm sure it's going to be an exciting time for you and your family. New opportunities, new neighbors, new job. I don't know how you sleep at night, just thinking about it.
It's hard. Thank you.
Do you have anything you want to say, Mark?
Well, I would like to say that, you know, that it has been an extreme pleasure to work here. As you've mentioned, Commissioner Kodich, that there's a lot of different projects that have come across my desk over the past 3 years. However, I think they were all projects that were aimed at making the county a better place. It's been enjoyable to work with this particular board. You were always agreeable and adaptable to dealing with the challenges. I don't think any previous board would have to deal with things like a COVID pandemic like we had to, and you guys were able to nimbly act on that, and was able to be able to work together so closely with you on being able to do things that service the county. I really appreciated that opportunity, and this truly is a bittersweet moment. I didn't really intend to leave, but this is a great opportunity for my family to leave. But I do have my heart here in Mifflin County still. We'll have family and friends here, and hopefully we'll be able to help out where needed going forward. It's something that I think it might be an opportunity to make this hopefully a smooth transition until this project can move forward, until you know, future staffing things are taken care of moving smooth. So thank you for everything.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, is there a motion to approve the
building? I think we got it.
Okay, we have change order number one with PVCI Allen Mechanical and Electrical for the Lewis County Senior Center to delete removable air purifiers for the cost of a decrease of $19,333.11. How long will we have to assess this coming month?
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chairman, Board of Commissioners. First of all, in the agenda, it does say Lewis County Senior Center, and that could be my fault, but anyway, that should be for the shelter services project. Okay. What we're doing here is we're taking out the air purifiers out of the bid, and we are then going to purchase those when the contractor recommended that. As a savings overall, it will leave about $8,500 in the budgeted amount then that we can purchase our own air purifiers, and then the contractor would not install them. We would take them down, the shelter wouldn't install them. So it was recommended by the contractor to do this to save some costs. So.
Thank you.
questions? I think it's just important that they are going to be installed.
Yes. Not the total number of 12, but we're only going to be able to get about somewhere between 6 to 8 due to the cost there. So.
Okay. Motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We have a subrecipient agreement with the Mifflin County Municipal Authority for the PDBG Village of Fosstown project. PDBG administrator Jessica Bowman.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm bringing a subrecipient agreement to you for this project in Granville Township. With the Village of Austin, Granville Township had previously owned the water system, and we developed a project that was previously approved last year. During the course of the project, as we're going through the bidding and collecting quotes and things for the project, Granville Township gave ownership of the water supply in the Village of Austin to the Mifflin County Municipal Authority. Therefore, we need to be able to establish a subrecipient agreement with the Mifflin County Municipal Authority that says that they're going to basically adhere to all the CDBG rules and regulations that we do. And the Water Authority passed this agreement yesterday at their meeting, and so I present it to you today for your approval.
Questions? Motion to approve.
So moved.
Second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under personnel, resignation of Lindsay Landis, part-time deputy sheriff, effective March 6, 2023. The rehire of Jared Knight, a part-time corrections officer, effective March 13, 2023. The promotion of Holly Yeager, a part-time tax services clerk, full-time tax services clerk, effective March 20th. 2023, promotion of Blaze Erzar, children and youth caseworker 1 to caseworker 2, effective March 20th, 2023. Promotion of Dylan Harlan, children and youth caseworker 2 to caseworker 3, effective March 20th, 2023. The hiring of Danielle Sheets for deputy coroner, effective March 20th, 2023. The hiring of Samantha Snook for children and youth caseworker, effective March 27th, 2023. Resignation of Corrections Officer April Hufenagel, effective March 30th, 2023. Resignation of Amy Torres, part-time human service assistant, effective March 31st, 2023. And rescind the hiring of Kylie Kettner, part-time planning technician, effective March 13th, 2023. So, motion to approve the personnel item.
So moved.
Second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
No further business. Stand adjourned.